In the early 1990s, I got invited to go somewhere that most people don't get to see, and that's into the locomotive of a freight train actually working and doing its deliveries and pickups. The engineer was a fellow that I knew from my former work, and he asked me to come along and document what his day was like as he was getting close to retiring. So we took the Southern Rail line from New Westminster all the way out to Chilliwack, all through Surrey and out to Chilliwack, picking up and dropping off loads through the entire day. This was shot on my CCD VX3, 3-chip Hi8 camera at the time. And, it's a look that most people don't get to see. Most people don't get to ride in a locomotive. I hope you guys enjoy it. I published this before, but it didn't get a lot of views, so I've since gone back and made some changes, and hope you guys enjoy this version. If I'm not mistaken, this is an EMD SW900 locomotive built by General Motors. Someone can correct me if I'm wrong, but I think that's the Loki that we're in. On our left, there is Frontage Road, which parallels Columbia Street in New Westminster, and you'll see the parkade there above the road, and that's now being removed and dismantled. So people that drive down this way now, or once it's finished, won't even recognize this, but this is what it used to look like, and this was actually used in many movies where they'd have a chase scene and they would shoot it in this area underneath this parkade. It never ceases to amaze me the stupid things that drivers will do when there's a train coming. Hello? Riding up in the locomotive, you get appreciation for the size and just the power of these things. I mean, it takes a train about a half a mile to stop. Think about that next time you try to beat a train at a crossing. We're going to see a few more close calls coming up here in a little bit as we go across several level crossings. And although we didn't have any real close calls, it was pretty close, but not scraping the paint. But there's a few of them coming up here that will just leave you shaking your head.
Yeah, well, just stop short.
Also, you'll notice gone is the dead man's pedal, where the engineer doesn't have to keep his foot on a brake release as he's moving. Everything's now become more automated, and there's a timer that will actually set off an alarm. And when the alarm goes off, so he has to push a button. And every time he moves a handle or a lever or anything, that resets the timer. But if he hasn't moved any controls over a preset time, it'll sound an alarm, and the alarm will get louder and louder and louder. And if he doesn't press a button to cancel it or move one of the controls, it'll actually throw the brakes on. So that's got away from the dead man's pedal, because as the engineer was explaining to me, what was happening was people would put like a brick or something on it so they didn't have to hold their foot on the pedal. Well, that doesn't do much good if your engineer has a heart attack and drops dead and their train is a runaway now because it's got a brick on the dead man brake. So now it's automated, and they can't cheat it. They have to be alert, because if they fall asleep or something happens, the train is going to stop. The bridge we're crossing is a swing bridge, so it can be opened to allow ships up and down the Fraser River. So the trains have to wait for the bridge to close, and then they can go through. A little ways back there was a camera that was pointing down at the tracks. That's so the operator of the bridge can verify that the tracks are properly aligned before turning on the signals to allow the trains to proceed. Directly ahead is the Patella Bridge. That bridge is now in the process of being replaced. There's going to be a new one put in there in the next five or so years. And over to the right of that is the SkyTrain Bridge for the SkyTrain system that passes parallel to the Patella Bridge. But we're way down low, because of course a train, you can't get the elevation. So that's why it's a swing bridge. And you can see the car traffic on the Patella Bridge dead ahead. And yes, that is a caboose there. Southern Railway is one of the few rail companies that still actually had a caboose at this point in time. The fireman is in the back. We have the conductor and the engineer up front. There's a three-man crew on this particular operation today. Okay, watch this one coming up. It's going to be a close one here.
Thank you.
So the conductor now has to go out and physically move the switch. You'll see the tracks. Well, he's going to throw that handle there. And that's going to throw the switch over to put us onto a siding to do a delivery. And then he has to go and remove a derailleur that's up the track. That derailleur is there in case another train comes along there, because the switch was in the wrong position. So that's to throw the train off the track so it doesn't tear up the switch further up the track. So now he's removed the derailleur. Now we can back the train down and drop off a load. And at this point, I'm standing on the back of the caboose, so the train's actually moving backwards at this point. At this point, we've dropped off all the cars that we had, and we're now heading out to Chilliwack to pick up a load. So the train's real short now. There's the caboose right behind the engine.
Tells us we've got a clear track where we go on to the coal train. Is there anything else that's caught up?
Some people just don't get it. Like, not only does one person have a death wish here, but so does a second one, right now. One thing I was told when I got on the train to start filming this is that whenever we are going by a level crossing, to always be leaning up against the actual Loki itself. Because if a car gets hit, we don't have seat belts, so you're going to go flying across the engine itself. So every time we're going across a crossing, I'm bracing myself just in case, because, well, as you can see, there's, you know, car drivers are just idiots. Coming up on the left is the old BC Electric Railway building.
Thank you. Thank you. Gorgeous grilling, big bars, yeah, down, yeah, and then off, and wrapped right over the top of that, yeah, bar.